Hello and welcome to this Prisma tutorial. My name is Frederick, and in this video I will show you an example for a complex long-term auction scenario which exists like that on the platform. This will get a bit complicated, so feel free to stop the video during my explanations to understand the graphically explained aspects. As before, since this is a theoretical approach, I will not use any units since they are not relevant for the understanding. And to make the description more understandable, I will speak about the total amount of capacity bid for, not the individual bids. The live example on the platform is the situation at the Dutch border, involving the network points Vreden-Winterswijk OGE and Elten-Zevenaar-Zevenaar. The initial setup is as follows. At the first bundle, OGE uploads 80 FZK to Vreden, GTS 200 firm to Winterswijk OGE, and at the second bundle, OGE uploads 100 FZK to Elten, ThyssenGas 100 FZK and 100 BZK to Zevenaar, and GTS 120 firm to Zevenaar. This creates a competition. Both these bundles then compete for the internal capacity on GTS side, which is 150. The matching by the platform is now done like this. At the Winterswijk-Vreden bundle, the uploaded 200 firm of GTS are reduced to 150, since this is the maximum capacity that can be provided on the internal side. Then, 80 firm and FZK are bundled, and the remaining 70 by GTS are offered as unbundled capacity. At the second bundling point, 100 FZK by OGE are bundled with 100 firm by GTS. On ThyssenGas side, 100 FZK are bundled with 100 firm of GTS, and the remaining 20 firm on GTS side are then bundled with 20 BZK from ThyssenGas. The remaining 80 BZK capacity are then offered unbundled. The results of both bundling point auctions will then compete for the 150 internal capacity, which I will call the bigger constraint, since it is the overall capacity that will be competed for. The small constraint is the available 120 capacity on the lower part of the constellation. This means you have 5 competing auctions in total in this constellation. A long-term auction example could look like this. In auction 1, we have an aggregated demand of 90, in auction 2 of 5, in auction 3 of 0, in auction 4 of 110, in auction 5 of 14, and in auction 6 of 70. The only auction that is not in competition is auction number 6, which ends after round 1 due to the undersell. Now, in a normal auction situation, auctions 2 and 5 would close due to the underdemand. But because auction 2 is part of the bigger competition constraint and 5 of the smaller competition constraint, the auctions continue until these constraints are fulfilled. In round 2, the demand for auction 1 is unchanged at 90, while auction 2 finishes with 0 demand. Auction 3 was already closed in the last round, auction 4 has a reduced demand of 97, with auction 5 being unchanged at 14 and auction 6 already being closed last round. This means the small competition constraint of 120 for auctions 3, 4 and 5 is fulfilled. Yet, the auctions will continue with large price steps, since the bigger competition constraint of 150 is not yet reached. The demand for auctions 1 and 5 is unchanged at 90 at 14, while the demand for auction 4 reduces to 30. Due to the over-demand in auction 1 and the reduced demand in the remaining two auctions, the platform decides to prefer auction 1 over the other two, during the partial allocation of the constraint. In practice, this means that auction 1 will get the full 80 capacity of the available 150, and auction 4 and 5 will have to share and compete for the remaining 70. Therefore, auction 1 continues with large price steps, and 4 and 5 try to reach the competition constraint of 70 with small price steps. In round 4, the demand in auction 1 is reduced to 60. Due to the first small price step, the demand in auction 4 increases to 80, while the demand in auction 5 stays at 14. Since auction 1 is the, by the platform, preferred auction, it is treated as a regular auction and does not have to compete for the available 80 capacity and will, due to the underdemand, proceed with a small price step. Since auction 4 and 5 now compete for the remaining 70 capacity, The small price steps will proceed until the overall capacity fulfills the competition restraint. This is the final round of this setup. Auction 1 closes with a perfect sellout of the 80 capacity. After the second small price step, both auction 4 and 5 result in an undersell, and the auctions close with 30 and 14 capacity. If you take this data and project it on the competition overview map, these are the results. I hope I could provide you with helpful information, but if you have any further questions regarding this topic, please do not hesitate to contact the Prisma customer care team. My name is Frederick, and I wish you a pleasant day.